Hello guys, welcome to Amazing Engineering, and today in this GeoGebra tutorial we will set the kinematic analysis of the four bar mechanism we made in the previous video. So let's start calculating the velocity of points C and B, remembering that they can be calculated as the product between the speed rotation of one of the members of the mechanism and the length of that mechanism. Let's suppose to know the value of the speed rotation of the crank. So let's create a number slider which represents the value of the crank rotation of the speed rotation of the crank, which we can call W2, and its value varies between 0 and 5. Let's set as value 2 radians per second. And the module of the velocity of C is equal to the product between W2 and the length of the segment CD, which is equal to the number slider M2 we used in the previous video. In order to represent the vector of this velocity on the mechanism, let's create a circle whose center is the point C, and its radius is equal to the module of the velocity of C. We know that this velocity is always perpendicular to the segment CD, so let's create a line perpendicular to the segment CD. Let's find intersection points between the line and the circle. The choice of the point depends on the direction of rotation of the mechanism. Because in this case we are considering a counterclockwise rotation, we have to choose the second intersection point. Let's link these two points with a vector, and this vector represents the velocity of point C. Now, in order to calculate the velocity of point B, because we don't know the value of the speed rotation of the fourth member of the mechanism, we have to use the Galilei-Varillon equation, where the velocity of point B is equal to the velocity of point C plus the velocity of point B in the relative motion with C. For this purpose, we have to create the so-called velocity triangle. So let's use a speed pole, which we can call V1. Let's represent the velocity of point C on the triangle. For this purpose, we have to use the command vector with given point and direction. So select the point P1 and the vector the velocity of C. And this vector represents the velocity of point C inside the triangle. Now we have to represent the direction of the other two velocities, remembering that the vectors follow one another in order to reach the resulting vector. So let's start to represent the direction of the velocity of B in the relative motion with C, which is always perpendicular to the segment BC, while the velocity of B is always perpendicular to the segment BA. Let's find the intersection point between these two lines. Let's link this point with vectors, where this vector represents the velocity of B, the relative motion with C, while this one represents the velocity of point B during its absolute motion. We can represent this vector on the mechanism using the command vector with given point and direction again. So select the point B and this vector. In order to calculate the modulo of the velocity of B, we can calculate the distance between the point P1 and the point F. So let's use the command distance. Selecting P1 and F. Now we can calculate the rotation speed of the fourth member of the mechanism using the ratio between the modulo of the velocity of B and the length of the segment BA, which is M4. And this is the value of the rotation speed W4. We can also calculate the velocity of the point B using the center rotation of the third member of the mechanism. And in order to get this point, we have to represent the lines perpendicular to the direction of the velocity of point B and C, which in this case, these lines are parallel to the segment CD and BA. So let's represent these two lines, and the center of rotation is the intersection point between these lines. We can call it P3. Now we have to calculate the speed rotation of the third member of the mechanism, W3, which is equal to the ratio between the modulo of the velocity of C and the distance between the point C and point P2. At the end, the modulo of the velocity of B, which we can call VB second, is equal to the product between W3 and the distance between B and the point P3. As you can see, we can get the same result using both methods. Now, in order to calculate the acceleration of points C and B, we have to remember that each acceleration is made up by a normal and tangent acceleration, which you can calculate with these equations. And if in this case we suppose to have a constant rotation speed of the crank, the acceleration at the point C is simply made up by the only normal acceleration. So the module of the acceleration of point C is equal to the product between the square of W2 and the length of the segment CD. We can represent this vector of the mechanism as we did before. So let's create a circle whose center is C and its radius is equal to the modulo of the acceleration of C. We know that the normal acceleration always faces the center of rotation of the point. So this vector will always be parallel to the segment CD. So let's create a parallel line to this segment. Let's find the intersection point. And in this case, we have to choose the first intersection point. Let's create a vector between these two points. And this vector represents the acceleration of point C. Now, in order to calculate the acceleration of point B, we have to use this equation, where each acceleration is made up by a normal and tangent acceleration. Now we have to create the so-called polygon of acceleration. So let's create an acceleration pole, which we can call P2. let's put the vector acceleration of point C in this polygon. So let's use the command vector with given point and direction. Select the point P2 and the vector of the acceleration of C. And this vector represents the acceleration of C inside the polygon. Now we can calculate the modulo of the acceleration, the normal acceleration of point B during its relative motion with C. And this acceleration is equal to the product between the square of W3 and the length of the segment BC, so M3. We can represent its vector, remembering that this acceleration always faces the point C. So let's create a circle whose center is the point B, and its radius is equal to the modulo of the normal acceleration of B in the relative motion with C. This acceleration is parallel to the segment BC. Let's find the intersection point between this circle and this line. We have to choose the first intersection point. Now let's represent the vector of the normal acceleration of B in the relative motion with C. Let's bring this vector to the polygon of acceleration. While the tangent acceleration of B in the relative motion with C is always perpendicular to the normal acceleration, so it is always perpendicular to the segment BC. So let's create a line perpendicular to the segment BC. We can calculate the modulo of the normal acceleration of B in its absolute motion, and it is equal to the product between the square of the speed rotation W4 and the length of the segment BA, so the number slider M4. Let's represent its vector on the mechanism. Create a circle whose center is the point B, and its diameter is equal to the modulo of the normal acceleration of B. This acceleration always faces the point A, so it is always parallel to the segment BA. Let's find the intersection point. We had to choose the second intersection point. And let's represent the vector of the normal acceleration of point B. Now let's put this vector on the polygon. While the tangent acceleration of B is always perpendicular to its normal acceleration, so it is always perpendicular to the segment BA. So let's make a line perpendicular to the segment BA. Let's find the intersection point between these two lines. Let's create two vectors. This vector is the tangent acceleration of B in the relative motion with C. And this vector is the tangent acceleration of B in its absolute motion. We can represent this vector on the mechanism using the command vector with given point and direction. Now, in order to calculate the resulting acceleration of B, we have to compose the normal and tangent acceleration of B using the parallelogram method. So, let's use the command vector with given point and direction. In order to create other two vectors parallel to the normal and tangent acceleration of B. Let's create a vector between these two points, and this vector represents the resulting acceleration of point B. Let's put it on the mechanism. We can hide the other vectors. Now, if we click on animation using the angular slider, we notice that both acceleration and velocity varies according to the values of the angle alpha.
Okay guys, this is all for today. I invite you to subscribe on my channel and see you for the next video.